Go this way.
Release.
Commander, кто работает на баке? На дроны не смотрите, пожалуйста.
Can we stop the
boat? Stop for a sec. We gotta catch the drone.
Alright, I shouldn't have pushed it this far. Okay. We gotta stop the boat, please.
Yep.
I think it was we came down too fast.
What was that, Renan? You said I should go or not go?
Yeah, I mean, we should probably start at the beginning.
Yeah, we embarked on this adventure to the remote Kuril Islands, and I think we had something like 25 drones and 22 cameras, and way too many photographers just chomping at the bit.
We've got a pretty like ragtag crew. It's a mix of scientists and photographers and adventurers. I immediately was hoping that we could fill the crew with inspiring, thoughtful, open-minded scientists.
If a bird poops on my head during this interview, I'm just gonna play it off like nothing happened, gonna continue my answer, and yeah, I'm a pro. That's why you brought me. I got a call from Taylor and Renan saying, hey, this might sound weird, but do you want to go on an expedition to the Kuril Islands? And I said, yes. And then I was like, where are the Kuril Islands?
The Kuril Islands are an island chain in the Pacific Ocean between Russia and Japan. And we knew we wanted to explore both the land and the sea. So initially I reached out to Jeff Kirby, he's a good friend of mine. He's an ecologist that had also used a lot of drone technology to survey landscapes. And I think it was around that time as well that I met Rishi, who is an ocean scientist and science communicator. Could you give us a demonstration of how you communicate with fur seals?
Yeah, it was something like...
They wanted a Swiss Army knife of a ocean scientist, and I guess that turned out to be me, and I was just super excited to have the chance to do something like this.
So it was the eve of our departure, and we're just prepping camera gear, and all of a sudden we get this call from Pavel, our producer.
Quick question, there's this random scientist that came out of nowhere that's trying to sneak aboard the ship.
So how did you end up on this boat? We were driving by and you stuck out your thumb and...
Yeah.
He's just said he'll sleep in the hallway. Do you think we should let him come? I don't know, like who is this guy?
Vladimir is a diamond. He's a diamond in the rough. An ecologist that's been working in this region for decades.
As a 61-year-old dude who's hitchhiking on, you know, tourist vessels just to get to his study sites, you know, it's really scary for him to not know what might happen.
So what do you hope, what are you expecting from this trip for yourself?
I just want to survey.
Only a few years ago, new technology showed up, popped up on our field research, it's the drones. That's amazing, an amazing device.
We're not being very helpful right now. Like, where would we be without him? Not here.
Yeah, that was the first day we watched Vladimir collect data, and it was really powerful to see. Populations of sea lions and seals in this region are declining, and he's literally the only person out there trying to understand why.
I'm very happy. It's a good day today.
Right now he's really excited because he has data. I'm really excited because we've seen him collect data and we've gotten a chance to be in the middle of something that is not of this planet. This is really cool seeing drones being put to use like this. He's done both mapping but also getting up close to look for individual information on the fly. So, big fight going on over there.
Yeah, every single photo that he was collecting, we would later find out and visit the island where it would be analyzed by his grad students who were building these whole programs to fully understand the population dynamics.
Runaway drone takeoff of the day.
That last one was gnarly.
I was power gripping it, but I couldn't hold it. And I saw it and I did like a last minute throttle up and it just missed all the antennas. So sketchy.
Taylor and Jeff and Vladimir, they were out there having this transformative experience on the island. And meanwhile, we're just back on the boat, teeing off with the drones, just trying to soak up as much beauty as possible.
I'm up in the air, climbing. Oh, wow.
Yeah, check out. That's the thing.
Wow.
Here they are.
They're surviving.
Yeah, they're surviving. And it would be good to check if any females.
At a certain point, I think we came to realize that all of these scenic flights, they actually had a purpose. It was like they were helping Vladimir's research and the teams were coming together.
I always wanted to share with other people, but I didn't have resources, I didn't have equipment to shoot to do it. You have that. And I'm really glad, I'm really happy that now more and more people could see it.
Yeah, one day on the boat, we were all having a conversation around social media, sharing stories, especially in ways that support science. And one thing led to the next, and Vladimir was like, do you think we should update my Instagram?
Right? I trust you.
Yeah, we're in it with you. Okay. I hence commence this moment, the origin of Big Daddy Gladiator.
Right.
May we all support Big Daddy Gladiator on his mission to continue data collection and good science in the Kuril Islands.
Okay, thank you.
On behalf of the mammals and the sea lions and everything that lives.
Big Daddy Vladdy Vladdy, Big Daddy Vladdy, hey!
Get like the siren going.
Big Daddy Vladdy is just the coolest scientist human I've ever known. His passion, his commitment. I mean, on like one of the last days of the trip, you know, after taking this wild ride with a bunch of hooligans, totally on a whim, not even knowing us, it turns out that the main purpose was so that he could bring fresh water to his grad students who'd been living on this island, you know, for months.
We monitor abundance and first rate pup production on this island. That's what only we can do with the resources we have. We have travel money and food money. And sometimes have a piggyback ride with a group like yours.
We can get water for the island.
Are you guys scientists here?
Yeah.
We're all scientists.
Me too.
Really?
Yeah.
My name is Ivan.
Ivan. Yeah. Rishi.
I'm Rishi.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet Rishi. You. Another drone expert with us also.
Really?
Who can help. Yeah. Me, not so much, but Jeff? Jeff is a drone master.
Drone? Drone master.
Yeah.
So, we have some problem with one drone.
Maybe you can show us around the building
a
little bit?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Let's go.
Okay.
So, you're welcome. It's a workspace.
Teaching the computer how to count, right?
Yeah. Now, this man teaching a neural network. About 6,000 pictures every day we make.
Wow.
Modern technology for post-processing. It looks like an artificial intelligence program which I produce. We have 34,700 animals for today.
First sales.
Wow.
First sale. It's too long because a lot of animals.
Yeah, it's good day.
How much time it takes? Like
Days.
Like day for today.
In 2016, we spent about 10 days for one full survey.
To pin each head of person.
But now it's require only 3 hours.
Wow, so from 10 days to 3 hours.
It's pretty good.
Maybe in two more years, 5 minutes.
A lot of people wonder, you know, what's the point of data? What's the point of science? But especially for ecology and the natural world, no policy change or protective measure has ever been put into place without scores of data from multiple people. So it's everything. It's how we understand. And you know, I guess the other side of that coin in terms of impact is storytelling.
Here we go. Nice.
It's like the kind of the pain and the love and the joy, but also the struggle of, I guess, trying to be a photographer that photographs landscapes is that you often photograph the places that you fear losing the most, you know? And I guess those are the ones that you want to share. I don't know, part of me is still wondering if I'm just dreaming, and this is like, this isn't even real.
There's often this big fear that technology might take away from these wilderness experiences. Especially with this trip, our circus of drones and cameras. But in the end, I think even Vladimir saw how important these new perspectives are as we move into the future.
Pretty good at this.
You know, when I was young, there was no video games.
What?
Really amazing. Pretty emotional. I've seen the ways in which technology has grown and evolved in the filmmaking world, as well as in science and data collection. And on this trip, it was pretty cool to see it all put to use.
making sure that this place is kept intact, kept functioning, and understood, even on a base level, understood in a holistic way is really important.
Data collection across one of the most important oceanic marine areas in the world.
And then more time you spend with those animals, and more you feel them, and you love them, and you care about them. It's important.